Are we literally spooning?
Yeah.
I love spooning.
Yeah.
What about like this?
So what I learned... Nice.
It's nice, isn't it?
Have you ever spooned in an interview before? No.
No, this is my first time spooning in an interview.
Do you have soft toys at home?
No.
Well, this is Tedley.
Oh, Tedley.
You're a good spooner. You're like, really, you've got me like well embraced. It's nice.
Yeah, yeah. You may as well fully spoon.
Yeah, I feel like I've
got half spoons.
I've gone back to the womb.
Yeah, great.
It's nice. Ah. Yeah, it's actually quite traumatic. No,
we'll do
not.
A rebirthing experience.
So... Where did your career actually begin?
Segway. From my earliest memories, which are about, you know, three, I suppose, I've always wanted to be an actress. I auditioned for a TV show called Mirror Mirror. I auditioned for the show called Mirror Mirror. You may have heard of it. Mirror Mirror. And I got that part. So that's how things kicked off professionally.
I read somewhere prior to that that you did a talent quest and where your skill was doing accents. And that's kind of where you felt it really kicked off.
Yeah, that was a really big night for me.
What were the accents?
Well, American, Australian, British, Irish, and somewhat inexplicably Dutch.
Can I please hear your Dutch accent?
And then I looked out the window and saw the flame. It was the most scary thing I've ever seen.
Like, what even is that? I don't know.
But no one else in the audience knew what Dutch was. So I still got first prize. Yes.
Yeah, you won.
I won. But other than that, I've just always wanted to be an actress. Such a New Zealand story, like my friend's mum's neighbour was an acting agent. And so that's why I was able to be signed up with them.
So you've really done quite well into managing to slip into a lot of New Zealand productions that have run for really long seasons.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, pretty unheard of around the world, let alone here.
Yeah. Yes, I am super fortunate.
So how many episodes has Westside done?
We've done 6 + 8 + 10 + 10.
Yeah.
Is that right?
I don't know what that is. It's 44 brief.
Have you ever thought about doing an interview series where you... and your interviewee just moon the whole time?
What, bums out?
Yeah.
Oh. Would you just have your pants down with your bum out?
Yeah.
When was the last time you actually mooned someone?
I don't think I ever have. Is that really boring?
No, but I reckon you should.
Okay.
Give it a go.
Yeah, just give it a go. Just.
I do a few cheeky moons every now and then.
Do you?
Yeah, do you guys do any moons? Has that ever happened to you? Has anyone just like yell out like, Pascal, Pascal?
Oh, I'm sure it has. But I usually just get West. People just yell West at me. Like, West. Or outrageous. Hey, outrageous. Outrageous lady. It's actually never the correct name of the show. Like, or the full name. It's never Westside or Outrageous Fortune. It's just, outrageous or West. West House lady.
I heard somebody somewhere that on stage you had to have an egg mixed with Worcestershire sauce.
Yes.
And drink that every night.
I did.
How was it?
Funnily enough, it was not a tradition. I kept up.
I've started looking at you like you've made me do this. Raw egg's meant to be good for you, isn't it?
I mean, sure.
Cheers, Tony.
Bottoms up.
Oh, no, it's okay.
It's nasty, but okay, eh?
Because how do you deal with the rejection as an actor? You know, I mean, say you audition for 10 roles and you're likely to get 2 of them. How do you deal
with
that?
Or none of them.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you the part that I missed out on where I've never been so devastated. I got really, really close to being a Power Ranger. And I just was put so much energy in wanting to get this part because I was like, my life needs to change. I need to get back on this acting train. Power Rangers is going to be the thing that does it. And then I didn't get it. And I was devastated. And I remember lying in my bed that night, looking up at the ceiling and feeling really scared about my life because I was thinking...
Do you still get that feeling of being scared that you might never get an acting job again?
Less so now. I used to more, but that experience was really formative because I was feeling those feelings that night, feeling really scared. I'm never going to be happy again. Acting's the only thing that makes me happy and I'm not getting any of this work. But then I did get Outrageous Fortune the following year. And in the break of Outrageous between season 1 and season 2, I did the next season of Power Rangers.
Mm-hmm.
And if I'd got that earlier role, I wouldn't have been able to do Outrageous because I was
Your life would have been very different. Yeah,
and so it just made me realize there is sort of a grand plan, it seems, that we do not know about in our small consciousness. So since then, I just am able to let go a lot more and trust that if a role is for me, I'll get it. And if it's not for me, if it's meant for someone else, then that's also fine. I definitely look back to look forward.
This is starting to feel like a bit of like a Sunday morning gossip fashion talk.
I
come, Tony comes around to my place on Sunday mornings and we just lie down, we spoon and we talk about fashion. Do you think you'll spoon interview? Next time you go into your interviews, you'll be like, I only
spoon.
Yeah.
I need intense cuddles before I will reveal anything.